So at Hootsuite, my title is Global Industry Principal for Financial Services. So really that's leading our financial services vertical and providing strategy to a lot of our enterprise clients. What I'm really excited about with digital marketing is this concept of building a social enterprise. You know, we've all talked about this changing customer journey and the fact that we're digitizing the customer journey, but we're not simply digitizing it, we're humanizing it. It's not simply the message being delivered in a different means through digital channels, but the very message itself is becoming more human. So really gone are the days of hierarchical marketing. Your message today is being carried through your employees, through your customers. And how do we empower those employees as brand ambassadors, empower a social sales force, social executives, and really building this concept of a social enterprise? Even with this concept of empowering a social enterprise, one of the biggest challenges is how siloed organizations are internally. So we see, when I talk often about the three key places of social, we see social advocacy, which can include executive influencers, general employees. We see social selling with advisors, wholesalers, or on the B2B side of things. We see corporate marketing. Now, the problem is they're all operating in silos, and often with all three with different goals and objectives, different technology even. And with social as the backbone of your digital communication infrastructure, it's really difficult to see the ROI and work with a cohesive plan if you have three different pieces of technology that aren't talking to one another. So really taking a step back and understanding what are the goals of the organization and should we kind of restructure how we're looking at this? When building that social media strategy, in financial services, the three core things that people are typically trying to achieve is they're trying to grow revenue, reduce expenses, and manage risk. And you can dive down into each of those a lot deeper to determine how you're doing that. But this is where it's really important to understand internally what are some of the costs associated with this, as well as working with your vendor to understand industry standards and what, you know, some of the competitors might be doing, so that you can really benchmark and help understand the overall value that the social media is going to provide. I think we don't have that right now, and because of that, social is still in this nice to have area instead of a mission critical. And really, as I mentioned before, social is the backbone of your digital communication. So we really need to take it from this nice to have to mission critical, and we're not going to do that unless we have the numbers that support it. When it comes to social listening, I mean, there's so much power in listening and being able to gain and competitive insight, product insight, what do your customers want, employee insight. So there's a lot that you can do when it comes to listening. And we approach listening. We do have listening available within our platform. We also partner with some really great companies like TalkWalker and BrandWatch that can really dive in deep and help segment out spikes in traffic around certain times. You can then zoom in on that and see who are the influencers, what caused that, was there a particular announcement, and follow through with those conversations. The thing to think about Hootsuite and what really differentiates us from some of the other companies in the market is we're all about this platform approach. We're not a point solution only for corporate marketing or only for advisors or only for employee advocacy. We're almost like your iPhone. So you have the Hootsuite platform, and then you can build your little folder of apps, and maybe for corporate marketing you need that deeper listening, so we would bring in a partner like TalkWalker or BrandWatch. Maybe your advisors, they want to connect to the CRM, maybe they're using Salesforce, so we can integrate Salesforce to the advisors. Compliance, we work with a number of great compliance partners, so really decoupling that marketing from compliance, so compliance can run silently in the background, while the marketers and the salespeople can do what they do best, which is go out, engage, interact in these conversations. I think one of the biggest challenges brands experience when engaging with customers is coming from a very robotic kind of approach. The first presentation was interesting this morning. Some of the stories they shared from Wendy's and some of these different brands. And especially in financial services, the whole compliance and regulation, there's a lot of challenges. People are a little scared to be more risky with this. But the reality is if you're going to look like everyone else, if you want to differentiate yourself, you need to be human. And maybe that lighthearted language doesn't come from the corporate handle, but that's where you really have an opportunity to share that message through your employees. Through your agents, through your executives. So social executives is a really hot topic right now, and TD Ameritrade is doing a great job getting that message out through their executives. So Tim Hockey is their CEO, and he's very active on Twitter, really humanizing the brand, making it more approachable, not just from a consumer standpoint, but for his employees too, and that it really has affected that culture. And so if it's you're not comfortable sharing that more casual language through the corporate brand handles, think about how you can empower your employees to have those conversations for you.